But John and Peter's testimony could not fully persuade a desperate people. So many of them only saw Jesus with the eyes of those long oppressed. And as the Nazarene made his way toward the gates of Jerusalem that final week, the people hailed him as the earthly king they hoped he would be.
Righteous song.
body, mind, and soul. Even the little children came to see him.
Thank you.
sit here while I go and pray.
Jesus, send us. His blessing upon me, this Holy One sent from above. Though I was his rock, I never deserved the wonderful gift of his love. The keys to the kingdom of heaven were mine, and all of the powers ever and glory divine. Time after time I denied you, yet you cared so much for me. Blessed Savior, hear my plea. Please forgive me. I remember when he told us that he must suffer and die. Although at first I did not believe, now it brings me cause to cry, as my guilt and agony deepen, I desperately search for a way to know once again that your love will restore this life that I give you. Yet you cared so much for me. Blessed Savior, hear my plea. Please forgive me.
Centuries of prophecy had come down to 3 years, and now 3 years had come down to 3 days. This is how the first day began. One balcony, two men in a tempestuous crowd. People of Jerusalem, cried Pilate, behold the man. What shall I do with the one you call King of the Jews, cried Pilate.
Crucify him. Crucify him.
Is this what you would have me do with Jesus, who is called the Christ? The crowd erupted, shouting, crucify him. Pilate cried, shall I crucify this king? The crowd shouted, we have no king but Jesus. Crucify him. sentence had been rendered. The condemned man was mocked and beaten. A rope of thorns was pressed into his brow. A blood-stained robe was around his shoulders. And as the first day slowly turned darker, Jesus began his final journey. Upon his back, he carried two crude pieces of wood and the sins of a grieving world.
Thank you.
The next day must have dawned gray and sunless. How can we imagine the hopelessness of that Saturday? How can we fathom the despair of a faith that has died? Jesus' followers were either immobilized by grief or hiding in fear. His accusers rushed to seal the tomb more securely. And on that second day, death appeared to have claimed the final victory. What would our world have become if it had ended all that day? What if Sunday had never come?
Suppose the stone had never stood, death had had the final word. What if the forces of darkness there had fallen? What if Christ was not alive and every hope had been denied? Where would we be if Sunday had not come?
Singing, singing, singing.
Sunday. It took 3 days to change the world, but it only takes one prayer to change someone's
life. I will lay down the burdens I've spent my life bearing, and confess I'm a sinner for whom Jesus died. I will live every moment in the light of his mercy, and I won't take for granted his loving.
We'll ask the ushers if they'll go ahead and get ready. And we have a special offertory by Linda. And I don't know who all else is going to do this. Larry Moplin's going to do it. So let's take an offering. Grateful for everything you'll give us.
Thank you. Happy Easter.
Thank you.